Friends, welcome to another video series, Principles of Equity Investing. In this video series, I am going to share with you my own learning from equity markets over the last 12 years. Well, my beginning was not too bad, but then suddenly in between with the 2008-2009 worldwide crisis, I had a disaster in the making. Half of my wealth had got wiped out. I was in the midst of my doctoral program, and then it was like sky falling. But thankfully, I did not lose my nerve. I first completed my doctoral work and then thankfully did not run away from equity markets. I thought of learning from my mistakes and then recover all my losses, not only in the absolute amount, but in many multiples thereof, I have been able to make profits. And therefore, I thought it will be very useful learning for people who get worried with the name equity markets, but who know that equity markets can actually provide them very high returns. So I want to build confidence in their mind that look at somebody like me who began with a failure, but then converted that into success. Of course, I'll pale in comparison with any big equity investor. But for a middle class person, being able to recover losses in multiples is not a bad thing. And if that helps people in building confidence, I think I have served, the community well. And the entire effort that I'm going to put in creating this video series will be really worth it if even 100 people benefit from these videos. So, this series is going to have 60 videos, who knows, 70, maybe 80. I already have a plan of 65, but maybe it'll unfold into more. I have discussed important principles which should be of help to you. In this particular video, I'm going to discuss about why of equity investing, for those who don't have familiarity. But even before that, I think it's worthwhile talking about what is equity in the first place? What is equity? Equity is the money raised by corporation from investors. A corporation can raise money from investors as well as from lenders. But the expectations of investors are different. The expectations of lenders are different. Investors are willing to take risk on business, but lenders go for a defined return. So equity is about investing. When we say equity, we are obviously wearing the hat of an investor. A unit of equity can be called as a share or stock. In some countries, collectively, the equity is also called as stock, particularly when it comes to capital. But these are synonymous terms. So essentially, what we should focus on is this principle that equity is about investing, not about lending money to a bank by way of a deposit, for example. Now, how do investors put money into the shares or stock? Essentially, that begins with an IPO. A corporation issues shares or stock to individual or institutional shareholders, and they in return get money. But one of the essential requirements of any investment is being able to exit from that investment. So once the money is raised by the corporation is never going to return it unless it decides by itself. So where do investors go then? The investors then go to the secondary market called as the stock exchange to buy or sell shares. So if somebody already has those shares, wants to sell them, he or she can do that through the stock exchange. Similarly, somebody doesn't have those shares or already has but wants to accumulate more, can also go to the exchange and buy more. Now the question is, why invest in equity? Equity provides superior returns, it beats other asset classes in long-term returns. This is more particularly true in the context of growing markets, where population is growing, opportunities are growing, demand is growing, corporations are growing. This becomes a fascinating opportunity for investors to share those profits. The tax treatment for equity in some tax regimes is more kind as compared to other asset classes, because equity investing involves much higher risk than other asset classes, and therefore quite often tax treatment is more comfortable, even that improves the return further. It also helps in beating inflation, because with inflation the corporation's profits also go up, and naturally the shareholders also benefit by way of increased share prices as well as larger dividends. Easy exit, we already talked about it. It also provides us exposure or opportunity to learn about different businesses. So that's fascinating. It also gives us a feeling of ownership of a corporation. Of course, our ownership is going to be a small fraction. That doesn't matter. We still are a part owner. Why not? I hope you have liked the video. Do press the like button. Your encouragement matters a lot to me. Do press the subscribe button to be notified about newer videos. And because I'm creating different series, learning finance, you know, success mantras for professional exams, creating a lasting organization, this series of equity investing, and many more, I have created playlists which will help you to see the videos in exactly that order in which I would like you to see them. So do benefit from them. I really appreciate your support. Thank you.